स्टैंडर्ड 10 सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 2 कल्चरल हेरिटेज ऑफ इंडिया ट्रेडिशनल हैंडीक्राफ्ट एंड फाइन आर्ट्स वेटेज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इन बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन इज ऑफ 3 मार्क्स 1 मार्क्स ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड 2 मार्क ऑफ 1 क्वेश्चन India is a country of rich cultural heritage. It includes materialistic and genetical heritage. A child gets physical and mental qualities from the parents by birth, which is known as genetic inheritance. Whereas house, land, estates like properties obtained from ancestors' forefathers is called material heritage. Similarly, whatever man obtains or creates with his understanding and skill is generally called cultural heritage. In the same manner, traditions, customs, rituals and special type of lifestyle which is adopted by our ancestors is also known as cultural heritage. In addition, other matters like education, farming, trade, rules and regulations of daily life, festivals, entertainment, art and handicrafts, beliefs, manyata and skills are also included in cultural heritage. India, being an ancient country of the world, has its best traditions, social values, dogma, principles, siddhant, customs and family system. So it is our duty to preserve, protect our cultural heritage. There are mention of 64 arts in our ancient literature. They are handicraft, workmanship skills, kasab art, drawing, music, dramatic arts and dance. Our ancient currencies were also valuable. Prosperity of India was main attraction for visitors to attack India. Today the education of yoga has been considered as a part of cultural heritage which has been accepted by the whole world. As a result of this, 21st June is celebrated as the World Yoga Day in the whole world. In this chapter, we will learn about different art and craft of India. Art of Indian artisans, karigar. The beauty of Indian cultural heritage is seen in traditional art of its artisans. They have skillfully developed different lifestyle of people through their remarkable art and handicraft industry. Weaving and embroidery, wooden art, clay work, drawing, painting, leather industry, animal work, sculpture, architecture, akik work, diamond related artistic workmanship, karigari and knitting work have been unique identity of India. Clay work. Man and clay have been closely associated since ancient time. The whole life of man revolves around it, from the cradle to the grave. Means jab tak wo zinda rehta hai, tab tak man ki jo life hai, wo puri land ke aaju baaju ghoomti rehti hai. Before the invention of metal, clay things were used much. Toys, pots, pitchers, earthen lamps, diye, clay stove, that is chula, clay vessels were made by the potters to store grains. Milk, ghee, curd and buttermilk were also stored in that clay vessels. Maximum kitchen vessels were made up of clay. The walls of the houses, kubas, huts were plastered by the paste of cow dung and clay. Even today we can see in the interior village of our country people using this plaster of cow dung and clay. We have got many clay utensils of red color that belong to Lothal, Mohenjo-daro and Harappa culture of ancient time. Potter's wheel is considered, mana jata hai, to be the best device for clay work in ancient time, India. In present time also, we can see garba, pitcher, means a pot which have holes in which we put earthen lamp diya during the time of Navratri. India was famous for producing the baked utensils of baked clay as well as unbaked clay that is known as terracotta. Since ancient time, this is known by seeing remains of old and handmade clay utensils which was found from Nagarjuna Konda in south and Lagnesh in Mehsana district. Next, art of weaving. The art of making long threads using small pieces of cotton from cotton balls swab and joining them together is called art of spinning. We all know that Gandhiji has given it a special importance as a cottage industry and joined it with Swadeshi movement to make us self-reliant Atmanirbhar under the banner of freedom movement, which has created a new history. Next is hand weaving. Since ancient time, India is known for its textile. It is well known that the whole piece of cloth of a particular size that we know by the name taka of the fine muslin of Dhaka could easily pass through a ring and could be adjusted in a matchbox. Moreover, carpet galicha of several regions, knitting work on attires, clothes and artistry etc. occupied a important place. Among them, patola of Patan, Kanjivaram and Banarasi saris, bandhani of Rajasthan and unique identity of India. During the golden period of Solanki era, Gujarat has progress developed in this field. During the reign of Siddharaj Jaisi, many artisans, weavers came and settled in Patan. The patolas of Patan became world famous due to their skills. This art of Patan is more than 850 years old. Only handful, few artisans have the skill for such a difficult and time-consuming art. The silkware bevadikt produced in Patan is called patola of Patan. Ikt means weaving. This type of sari is designed in such a manner that it can be worn either sides, means it can be wear on both the sides. This type of patola variety had a good durability, means ability to last long, and its original color remains intact, which does not fade. There is a saying in the same reference in Gujarati, padi patole bhat fate pan fite nahi. The design laid down in patola shall never fade even if the cloth may be torn. Next, art of embroidery. The work of embroidery can be seen on the clothes of the idols and statues which were found during the excavation of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. The art of weaving on the clothes of men, women and children is very famous from the ancient time. This art of embroidery was seen on the clothes of men, women and children in Sindh, Saurashtra and Kutch region at the time of the Indus civilization. Similarly, Kashmiri Kasab work of Kashmir is also well known. Apart from embroidery, bandhani of Jamnagar, Jaitpur, Bhuj and Mandvi of Gujarat are very famous. The traditional style of bandhani, with all its luster, smoothness and due to the beautiful designs of elephant puppets at like Katputli, dyes and picture, is very popular today. Cottage industry was taken over by the women of Kutch and Saurashtra regions of Gujarat. The traditional art of embroidery, torans, chakda, pillow cover, bed sheets, shak, todalia, clothes like kedia is well known even today. embroidery work is also carried out on quilt, that is rajai, and shawls with different designs. Embroidery work of Jat community of Bani area of Kutch is unique in itself. Next, leather industry. Skin of dead animals was used for various purposes in ancient India. After the death of animal, its skin was removed and processed in a traditional manner. Leather was prominently mainly used for making mashak, a leather bag for fetching water, and coarse drum, dholak, tabla, musical instruments, and the bellows used by blacksmiths, and various types of footwears, leather belts to tie animal, etc. Leather was also used to prepare shield, which was used during wars. Leather industry had a important place in ancient India. Well-knitted mojris of Rajasthan, shoes, leather-knitted purses, belt, and other things made out of the leather for horse and camel, like saj, palan, lagam, and whip, means a kind of a chapuk to beat animals, were very much in use. Diamond bead work and enamel work. India has 7,517 km long coastline surrounding all three directions, east, west, and south. So diamonds and beads are available in plenty. There has been a wide, much use of gems and diamonds since ancient times. Since ancient time, trade of diamond and beads were carried out through sea route with different countries across the world. Diamond-studded ornaments have been in a great demand in foreign countries since long time. The world-famous diamonds like Kohinoor and Great Mughal were found from India only. As Indians are fond of diamonds and beaded ornaments, variety is found in great deal. Means a large number of variety of ornaments related to diamonds and beads are found in India. Earlier, rich and royal people used to wear diamond jewelry apart from gold ornaments. Diamonds, rubies, beads, emerald, and topaz were used to adorn and beautify the throne and crowns, and jewelry like bracelet and garland, means har, etc., of kings. Beadwork is also found important in Gujarat. The beautiful bead torans, pachit, pots, bari, door grills, frames, chakda, a traditional wall piece, decorative coconut used at the time of ceremonies known as lagnanu, nariyal, indhoni, modia, a net which covers the mouth of a bullock, horns, hand fans, animal back cover, jewel, etc., are knitted in a unique artistic way. India has been a leading country in jewelry since time immemorial. India is the only country in the world where experts can be seen in enamel work. Apart from the gold and silver work, enamel work means the artistic skill, kala, of inlaying the bright colors like red, green, and blue in gold and silver ornaments like rings, bangles, earrings, keychain, chain, etc. Experts of enamel works are seen especially in Jaipur, Delhi, Lucknow, Varanasi, and Hyderabad. Next, jari work. Jari work is seen in India since ancient time. Golden and silver threads are woven with clothes, and embroidery is done with gold and silver threads to decorate the clothes. Surat is an important place for jari work. Knitting and embroidery of Jardoshi work have a unique beauty. Even artisans of Surat could make beautiful dresses like sari, panetar, ghar chola, etc., bordered with jari if needed. Next, metalwork, engraving. Metalwork is also a very old form of an art of India. Metal age began and developed after stone age. The artisans of Lothal made different weapons like sickle, drill, curved saw and needle, etc. with copper and bronze. Moreover, they prepared utensils, idols, murti and pots. Arms and ammunitions for war were made up of metal. Gold and silver were used for making ornaments. Copper, brass and bronze were used to make utensils and idols, whereas iron was used to make instruments and weapons. Next, wooden art. Man, trees and forest are closely associated with each other. Initially, Shuruaat mein wood was used as a firewood, later on for making weapons, construction of buildings and other constructive work. Gradually, wood was used for different purposes, like for making idols, toys for children, wooden pillars, windows and doors, small huts on top of terrace, thrones, chairs and grills. In this way, wood carving was developed. Wooden furniture like swing and toys of Idar and Sankheda found in Gujarat is well known. Inlay work. Inlay work is considered to be very ancient art of India. Indian king, emperors, rulers and royal people of that time used to wear ornaments and necklace, bracelet, crown, ring, nose ring, damni, tiko, etc., were studded with precious gems like diamonds, pearls, rubies, etc. Artisans were expert in the work of inlay art. Bikaner area of Rajasthan is more popular for inlay ornaments. Next, akik work. Akik is a kind of precious stone, especially found in valley area of the river. It is mainly a kind of a limestone mixed with silica, blue or white stone. Carnelian akik is mainly stone with semi-transparent quality and beautiful red in color, means wo half transparent hota hai aur half red in color. In Gujarat, various precious stones are available in big and small size at Rangpur and Surat. All these stones are sent to Khambhat to mold into various beautiful ornaments with various designs. Beads and garland hair of stones are prepared by them. Next is painting. Of all the arts, painting is foremost important one. Painting is an art which can be expressed through lines and colors. The aim of these art is to express emotions, feelings by imitating, copying the animate and inanimate objects. Animate means live and inanimate means non-living objects of nature through lines and colors. We have proof of Indian art of painting from the remains of 5000 year old Harappan culture. Various models of paintings have been found out many times by the archaeological department during excavation work. We have traces found of the picture of animals and birds in the cave painting of primitive man of stone age at Bhimbetka, MP. people used to draw geometrical designs and sketches. Elephant, rhinoceros, deer are notable among them. Ajanta Ellora are incomparable specimen, great specimen of such paintings, drawing the sketches of swastik, which are Ganesha at the time of festivals and celebration, is an old tradition of India. Rangoli making is also a very old tradition in some of the regions of India. Next one, fine arts of India. Singing, playing, dancing and performing roles of different characters is a unique feature of Indian culture. Entertainment with moral education has been imparted since ancient times through dramas based on the greatest scriptures like Ramayana and Mahabharata. Means from the ancient time in India, dramas are performed on Ramayana and Mahabharata. Music. Indian music is different in the whole world from the point of view of tune, rhythm and harmony. And so it is different from the music of other countries of the world. Samveda, one out of the four Vedas, is considered to be associated with music. Richas of Samveda are sung with tune and rhythm of music. Music involves both singing and playing. Sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni are seven vowels of music. Indian music can be divided mainly into two parts, classical music and folk music. We have five ragas in classical music: Shri, Deepak, Hindol, Megh, Bhairavi. It is believed that all these ragas naturally came out of the Panchmukhi of Lord Shiva. In ancient India, many texts, written document on music are there, out of which the introduction of three, Sangit Makrand, Sangit Ratnakar and Sangit Parijat, is given below. First one, Sangit Makrand, a musical scholar Narad, who had written Sangit Makrand in about 900 BC. It describes 19 veenas and 101 rhythm which are useful even today. Second one is Sangit Ratnakar. The writer of this text was Pandit Sarangdev. He lived in Daulatabad, Devgiri, so he was familiar with South and North Indian music. Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhatkhande considers Sangit Ratnakar as the most authentic, accurate book of music. Sangit Ratnakar is believed to be unique in understanding all the aspect of music. Yani we can get understanding of all the aspect of music in Sangit Ratnakar. Third one, Sangit Parijat. Sangit Parijat is a very important book on music. Pandit Ahobol had written this text in 1665. On Northern Hindustani music. He had noted one important characteristic feature of all the ragas, saying that the ragas have their own individual identity. Yani har ek rag ka alag identity hoti hai. He has described 29 types of tunes. During the time of Alauddin Khilji, talented Amir Khusro was very famous. Due to his contribution, Yogdan, in the field of music and poetry, he was known as Tota-e Hind, Parrot of India, in Indian history. Bhakti movement started in India in 15th and 16th century. Bhakti Sangeet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Kabir, Tulsidas, Mirabai and Narsi Mehta etc. was very famous. The disciple Shishya of Swami Haridas, Baiju Bawra, Bajinath, Tansen and duet girl Tana Riri are considered as rare jewel of music of 15th century. Next one is dance. The word Nritya has been derived from the original Sanskrit word Nrit. Dance is one of the mediums of realizing beauty with taal and lay, that is harmony and rhythm, for the realization of ascetic true joy. Shiva, the originator of dance, is the lord of dance. Shiva is therefore also said to be Nataraj. He was the first to bring down music from the heaven to the earth to teach these art of dance to the people. India has wide variety of traditional classical dances like Bharatanatyam, Kuchipudi, Kathak, Kathakali, Orissi and Manipuri. First one, Bharatanatyam. The origin of Bharatanatyam is believed to be in Tanjore district of Tamil Nadu. There are two books on Bharatanatyam, Natya Shastra written by Bharat Muni and Abhinav Darpan written by Nandikeshwar, which are the original sources of Bharatanatyam. Apart from Gopi Krishna and Mrinalini Sarabhai, the actresses like Vaijanti Mala and Hema Malini etc. are considered to be the preservers of this heritage, means they are the dancers who perform Bharatanatyam. Kuchipudi, the style of dance which was created in 15th century, it is mostly based on the description on woman's beauty. Different poses and gestures formed by male and female dancers are woven together in the foundation of this dance. Kuchipudi is famous dance of Andhra Pradesh. Guru Prahalad Sharma, Raja Reddy, Shobha Naidu etc. are the well-known dancers who have preserved this ancient tradition till today. Kathakali, this style of dance is very famous in Kerala. The word Kathakali has been derived from the dramas which are based on ancient epic Ramayana and Mahabharata and mixed drama of Sanskrit and Malayalam language. The characters of these art wear beautiful plaited attires, clothes. We have to read their facial expressions to recognize, to find out the characteristics, qualities of the character. The crown they put on is very artistic, decorative. The character performs his or her dance with facial expressions and poses of hands to introduce the characters of Trilok. They come in front of the curtain with the light of earthen lamp diya only. Poet of Kerala Sri Vallathod founded Kalamandal Kathakali, Kalamandalam, Krishna Prasad and Shivaraman, etc. have earned great fame in the nation and worldwide. Next, Kathak dance. The line Kathak kare so Kathak kahave is related to the Kathak dance. The Kathak dance narrates the life events and incidents of Lord Krishna. Means it is based on the life incidents of Lord Krishna. It is observed that it has developed with Shringar Bhakti. Ye mana gaya hai ke this dance has developed due to the Shringar Bhakti, which belong to the Vaishnav community. In this style of dance, dancer turn around on one leg and shows reference of dances and performs the dances. Women wear narrow trousers and frilled, that is kind of a frock type attire cloth. This style of dance has been kept alive today till today by Pandit Sri Birju Maharaj, Sitaram Sitara Devi, Kumudini Lakhia, etc. Next, Manipuri dance. The people of Manipur dance on every occasion and festival. This dance style is chiefly based on Ras Leelas and Bal Leelas of Sri Krishna. Manipuri dance is divided into two types, Lasya and Tandav. The plaited green colored petticoat is known as Kumin, and at the same time silk blouse and a belt are put on around the waist, as you can see in the picture. Guru Abhomi Singh, Atombo Singh, Guru Bipin Sinha, Naina Zaveri, Nirmal Mehta, etc. have gained worldwide fame. Next one, dramatic art. Presenting sanskar with entertainment is the unique feature of Indian dramatic art. Apart from this, anchor and funny pair of clowns entertain audience. Natya Shastra by Bharat Muni is well known in the field of art. Dramatic art, writing of drama and performance of drama along with audiovisual aids, these three things holds the capacity to entertain the people of all age group. Dramatic art is an combination of all the arts. Describing it, Bharat Muni says, there is no book, there is no sculpture, there is no knowledge, there is no work which is lacking in dramatic art. The first drama of Bharat Muni was Devasur Sangram in Sanskrit literature. We have various well-renowned famous dramatists. Bhas is the poet of poets among them. He has bequeathed, means given us, dramas like Karnabhar, Urbhanga, Dutvakyam based on Mahabharata. Whereas Kalidas, the foremost poet, gifted us play like Abhigyan Shakuntalam, Vikramavarshivyam and Malvikagnimitram. Apart from above, many dramatists came and enriched, improved the dramatic art of Sanskrit literature. The name of Jayashankar Sundari is foremost in the dramatic art of Gujarati. Besides Amrut Nayak, Bapulal Nayak, Dina Pathak, Jashwant Thakur, Upendra Trivedi, Praveen Joshi, Deepak Ghiwala, etc. are remarkable playwrights, means a person who writes play and dramas. There is a greater contribution of regional and other drama institution in this field. Next one is Bhavai. Script writers have said that Bhavai is feeling based drama. It is special dramatic art that started 700 years ago by Aset Thakur. These art which has been providing public education along with entertainment at the economical rate. It was promoted during Solanki era. It was chiefly performed without curtains. with light humor comedy and with the music playing on trumpet. Characters disguised in the form of Ramdev, Jhandajhulan, Kajodo, etc. are the main features characters of the Bhavai. Theme of Bhavai includes protest against social vices. In Bhavai, we can see they protest against the social evils of the society. The characters like Ranglo Rangli are used to promote the program like girls' education and save the girl child, etc. Those who perform these Bhavai play trumpet and pray to goddess by reciting hymns, means by praying to goddess. Folk dances of Gujarat. There are different dances forms belonging to different communities of Gujarat. These dance forms are according to the traditions and customs. Among them are tribal and folk dances, Garba, Rasa, and many more folk dances. Such art of dance can be seen at the time of festivals, marriages, and fairs. Tribal dances. Tribal dance of Gujarat is seen at the time of festival, marriages, fair, and to please prasan karne ke liye the god and goddesses. Most of dances are performed by forming a circle along with various traditional musical instruments like drum, traditional manjira, thali, dholak, with songs in regional language. In the dances form known as chado, means a kind of a dance is there which is known as chado, in which characters imitate, copy different bird creatures like peacock, squirrel, and sparrow. Dance like Malino Chalo and Thakaryo Chalo are seen in Dang district of Gujarat, whereas Tippani dance of laborers, that is known as Shramhari, performed by Bhil and Koli communities, dancers perform dance in group on the set of thick sticks which are joined with small sticks which they struck to the ground. Next one, Garba. The word Garba is derived came from the word Garbadeep. Earthen lamp is placed in a hold earthen pot. Dancers keep it on their head and move around in circle. Garba are performed during the Navratri festivals in Hindu month of Aso Sud Ekam to Aso Sud Navami, or somewhere up to Dasam or up to Sharad Poonam in all the parts of Gujarat. Gujarati people perform and sing Garba to worship and pray Adya Shakti, goddess of power, mother Jagdamba. Generally, it is performed in the open ground encircling to the Mandvi, which is kept in the center of the ground, along with the stroke of hands, tali, and beat of drums. Gujarati poetry known as Garba and Garbi are mainly associated with Krishna Bhakti. Gujarati poet Dayaram wrote poems in Gujarati, which made spelling mistake is there, ladies sing the colorful and emotional Garbi of Lord Krishna's love. Next one is Rasa. Rasa is a dance to be performed in circle along with singing. There is a story that Lord Krishna had shown Raslila to devotee that is known as Bhakt Narsi Mehta. Rasa is a mostly performed in Gujarat during Navratri and Janmashtami festivals. Dandiya Rasa is one of its type, but some people perform Ras by placing earthen pot on the head. Due to increasing influence of Vaishnav sect, importance of the Vaishnav sect, Rasa has become more popular. Women wear traditional dresses like embroidered chaniya choli, and men wear embroidered kedia dhoti when they perform or play the rasa. Next, other dances of Gujarat. In that first one, Gof Guthan dance. It is performed on drum beats and tal and laya of music, tying rope with mandap, pillar, tree, and holding the other end of the rope in the hand. They perform dance in group, holding the rope in one hand and the dandiya in the other hand. They make creeper, means bell jaisa structure formation, going one inside and other coming outside. This is repeatedly done, forming a circle. This way they make and open the guthan, that is known as plate in English. This style of dance is called Gof Guthan dance. Next one, Dhamal dance of Siddhis. See this, presently who are residing in the Jambur village in the center of the Gir, actually originally they belong to Africa, perform this dance. They perform dance by rhythmically striking mashira, which is made up of coconut shell containing earthen, in which earthen lamp diya is there, covered with a cloth. They wear a peacock feathers and hold small drums in their hand, forming a circle. They dance with high and low pitch sound intonation of hu hu, which echoes in the whole forest. They dance in a group, imitating, copying the voices of animals and birds. Third one, Merayo dance, Padhar dance, and Kodyo and Mir dances. These type of dances is seen near the step well wav of Banaskantha region. Toran is woven with the tall grass of reed and Junjhadi, that is a kind of a grass. These dances performed on drum beats and sword tricks, talwar. These type of dance is called Merayo dance. In Surendranagar region, the people of Padhar community dance with tal and lay of dandiya and manjira. While dancing, they generate scene like sea waves or like a ship which is moving on a sea waves. Kolis of Saurashtra perform Koli dance, holding madarsio, which is a colorful cloth for tying on head and headgear, turban, pagri, which is decorated with embroidery and mirrors, abla, tied with green colored embroidered bell. They wear bhet on their waist to perform this dance. Similarly, Mer dance of Saurashtra and other dances of Bharwa tribes are also well known. As we discussed in the previous chapter, here also we find that Indian culture is universal, assimilating all, means it is a combination of all. As a result of arrival of various tribes since ancient time to contemporary, means present one, many changes occurred, like growth and development of handicraft, home artistry, painting, dancing, and various other fine arts. This shows rich and different heritage of India, and it leaves permanent impression, sense of India on the outlook of the world. Thank you.